Can you just take us through, how does it feel to be one of the artists that are actually like the artists that were chosen to be part of the Red Bull Music Festival?
It feels really, really crazy. You know, when I met with Red Bull at the beginning of the year to talk about like what I was doing for the year and how they could get involved, they mentioned this festival to me, but I didn't know the scale that was on me. It was absolutely insane. Like, I got a great day quite often. I mean, until is always holding it down, I think. But tonight was something very, very special, and I think it's just been a really, and I feel honored and I feel blessed. You know, when you're on a Red Bull lineup, you're kind of like an extreme, it's like you're like a skateboarder. You know, some people play soccer, I mean, you're a skateboarder. So in the musician world, I'm like a skateboarder.
Yeah.
So it's really, really dope.
In your opinion, what would you say is the one thing that Red Bull is doing differently as compared to other brands?
I think one thing that Red Bull does do very differently is that they allow artists to do what it is that artists do, which is just like to grow and make music and do whatever it is that they do. Because a lot of the time when you collaborate with other brands, you kind of have to do something different from what it is that you do on a regular basis. And Red Bull just like plugs into what it is that you're doing and what it is that you're about. Also, the amount of female artists that they had on this lineup is something that's very rare in Johannesburg. Usually there's like the one sympathy female or the one who's whatever, you know? Like, there were so many. I mean, on one night alone, there was Rouge, myself, Moonchild, all killing it. That's crazy. So, shout out to me.
Thank you, Pedro. Shall we? Let's do it.
I did Red Bull campus tour first, which kind of gave me a good workout for what I can do and what I shouldn't do, which songs work, which songs don't work. But this is the city that I'm from, you know, I spent a lot of time here. I've shot so much in drum, but I've never performed here before, so I didn't really know how to prepare. I think I spent more time like today getting my outfit together, so I didn't focus on the nerves, because Joburg crowds are really tricky. Like, if a Joburg crowd is not rocking with you, they really are not rocking with you. So instead of just being nervous today, I threw all my energy into my outfit, and I'm glad I did that, because it really came together. But for me, it was just about like getting familiar with the Red Bull vibe and the energy, and the Red Bull campus were really allowed us to do.
Yeah, but I can tell you've been busy. If I'm not mistaken, there's something that you're going to surprise us with.
Yeah.
So can you just give us, like, what should your fans expect throughout the course of the year?
I think the main thing that I'm working on is my album. It's called Victory, and I'm hoping it's going to be out in the next time. But I'm really, really excited about it. We started recording it in the record studios in Cape Town, which is amazing. Gemini Majors is executive producing the whole project, Psycho Beats did some stuff on me. So, yeah, it's going to be super dope. We're back in Joburg now, so we just finalizing all the features. We've already got Youngstar on there, we've already got Patty Malone on there. So we're hoping to do some stuff with Shekinah, with all the bands, obviously with my brother Liz. So there's a lot of work to still be done, but I'm very, very excited about it. It's called Victory. It's going to be released independently through my record label, and it's my brand of music, which I'm extremely proud of. And yeah, I can't wait for you guys to hear it.
Tell your bitches to relax. Everybody just relax. Yes. Tell your bitches to relax. Tell your bitches to relax.
Everybody must relax.
Wait,